Thanks.
When I die... Thank you, good night. When I die, I want to be buried with my horse. Not that I'm overly fond of him or anything. I just want the future to think I was a centaur. Like the first three words of Lowe and the... I recently received a tip that I was about to be the victim of a surprise audit. So I spent the next 2 days at the paper shredder so there'd be enough confetti for the surprise. I was recently let go, a bunch of us. I worked at the poster board factory. It was a mass layoff. It was very unfair. And the worst part about it was we really had no way of protesting. Here's a little about me. I like to go around poking people with safety pins. Just to shake up their faith in everything. He's a little slower than everyone else. I started seeing a hypnotist. By that I mean I'm dating her. She's ugly as sin, but there's something about the way she snaps her fingers. Apparently, I'm no longer allowed to make her breakfast in bed ever since she rolled over on a hot frying pan. I was in the emergency room the other day, and there was a guy there in a wheelchair, and his head was all bandaged up. So naturally, I said, "What happened to you?" He says, "Well, I was up on the roof cleaning the gutters, and I fell off." I said, "Oh my God, you're lucky to be alive." He said, "Yeah, but in all honesty, I had no business being on the roof in a wheelchair." Sometimes, to mix it up a little bit, I'll drive home a way that I normally don't, like in reverse. I've got a photograph. I'll just start over. I've got a photographic memory. People ask me if I was born that way. I said, no, that's something that develops. That's what we call a bad joke. I remember at family functions, my dad was always breaking out the home movies. I also remember having to audition. I bought a second-hand crystal ball so I could see the future, but for only for shit that's already happened. It's a crystal ball. My girlfriend threw me a surprise going away party. I had a dream last night where I shit all over myself, and it was a disgusting mess in my pajamas and in the sheets and in my hair, because in my dreams I have hair. It was awful. When I woke up, luckily everything was fine, except my boss was standing next to me. And he said, "Get back to work. This bus is not going to drive itself." I thought, wait a minute, why would he be on the bus with me, you know? And I realized it was one of those dreams within a dream. So I woke up again, covered in shit. I've been waking up lately with these very potent erections. Which normally wouldn't bother me, except they're on my face. That's a joke I like to call "Good Morning, Gentlemen." I accidentally sent a naked picture of myself to my mother in the mail. Hey, here's a fun trick. I'm gonna record you if you don't. don't mind. On the count of three, oh, I don't know, just shout out your favorite color. One, two, three, go.
Green. Whoa.
All right, check this out. Thank you very much. I threw a dinner party the other day, and it was, my brother came home, he brought his wife, and she brought a friend of hers from college, and she was just beautiful, and so fun to talk to, and hilarious, and I really wanted to get to know her, but we all had too much wine and fell asleep, and she slept on the couch, and I thought, well, it's breakfast, I'll really talk her up at breakfast, but by the time I woke up, she had already gone. But when I went to the bathroom, she'd written her name and phone number on the mirror and lipstick. So I don't know the protocol for this kind of thing, but I called her right away and said, listen, I don't know if this sounds weird, but I'd like you to come back here as soon as possible and clean all this shit off my mirror. My girlfriend told me she needed a little space, so I took her to the planetarium and broke up with her. I read something interesting about Sherlock Holmes. It turns out he never actually says, "Elementary, my dear Watson," that's in the movies or whatever. I thought that was kind of cool. I dug a little deeper. It turns out he never says, "No shit, Sherlock," either. It's been a rough week for me. I got maced the other day. I was at a Renaissance fair. I started a fight club recently, but it's a non-violent fight club, so mostly we just get together in parking lots and argue. So far, it's just my mother and I. The funny thing about radioactive decay is that it's not reversible as a function of time. So what I mean is if I take a chunk of uranium and I run it forwards in time for a while, eventually it's going to turn into lead. Where the converse is not necessarily true. If I take a chunk of lead and run it backwards in time, it's not going to turn into uranium. Now the interesting thing is if I take a chunk of uranium and run it backwards in time, I can make a shitload of money off the Cold War. Still fairly relevant. I live in the basement of a treehouse. People act like the only options we have nowadays are gas or electric, and that's not true. There's lethal injection. Start with that guy. Too far. I'm just trying to piss everyone off before I leave. Whenever my dad would come home from work, my mother would say, "Well, there's a sight for sore eyes because he traveled. He was on the road all the time, and when he came home, he would punch in the eyes." Everybody's familiar with the Fonzie statue? The bronze Fonz, we did a statue and it's a big deal, and he's it's like this, and it's kind of stupid what people take the pictures with. Well, I was down there, and we were taking pictures, and I thought it'd be funny to put his thumb in my mouth, which was an awful idea. I don't recommend it. It tingles. I thought I was going to get sick. And my friend was there, and he said, "Hey, stupid, how's it taste?" I said, "How do you think it tastes? It tastes like copper." He said, "Oh, like when you get blood in your mouth?" I said, "No, that's iron that tastes like blood." And he's like, "I'm pretty sure it's copper." And I'm like, "I'm pretty sure you're an idiot, because it's iron that's got the hemoglobin in it, and that's what goes through blood. And needless to say, the whole thing escalated into this wrestling match where I accidentally elbowed him in the mouth. And he says, "Thanks a lot. Now I'm bleeding." I said, "How's it taste?" He said, "Irony."
Michael, you got it.